Alpha. Unto you this day, Lord, that you accept our worship. Eternal Rock of Ages, even while here on earth, we pray that you will fulfill the purpose, the eternal purpose of worshiping you, of being the vessel unto honor of your holy name. Our Father and our God, even at this hour, we pray, King of Glory, that you will speak life into our lives. Let your word be deposited into our spirit and cause the power in your name to actualize even the purpose of our being in the name of Jesus. Father, let there be no interference to our blessings. Let there be no hindrance unto our achieving purpose. In the name of Jesus. I pray that I will not speak of myself, of the flesh, or human intellect, philosophy of men. I pray that your word will come from the throne of grace. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. You are wonderful. God bless you. Maybe I should join your WhatsApp so that I can also be dressing on point. Amen. Hallelujah. Our God is awesome. Very, very awesome. This morning, we were going to, it was planned that we were going to have a guest minister, and we didn't get to get that to happen. So I was trying, early in the morning, I was praying that what should we have shared from the throne of grace? And God led me to two things which I have put down. Lo and behold, when we came to the workers' prayer meeting this morning, the vessel, the daughter of Zion, God prepared exactly the same thing. And I was going to say, okay, let's record it, because all that I put together, she rounded up in 10 minutes, maybe less than 10 minutes. I said, okay, this will be recorded so that people can, but I think I should still share it in a different perspective. Praise the Lord. All of us, if you had lived at least one day on the face of earth, it's most likely that you would have made a mistake. It could be a mistake, or maybe you took a decision, or you took an action that led to some consequences that you may not like or envisaged. And it might be a correct decision that you took on the face of it. By the time you were taking the decision, all the parameters, everything around your taking decision suggests that that was the best option. But there could be other things that would determine or that would interfere with that course of action that would lead to a muddling up of the result. You understand what I'm saying? What I'm saying in summary is that we could take wrong decision, we could make mistakes, but sometimes we make the right decision based on the facts before us. And other things will happen beyond our control that could lead to those decisions not resulting in the envisaged outcome. When such happens, whether we made the mistake, whether we took an action, whether we made the best, but it was beyond our control, the position we find ourselves sometimes could make or mar. How we proceed from there could make or mar our purpose. Let me break it down. If we had made a decision in the past, whether rightly or wrongly, and the result is unpalatable, if we don't undo the result well, it could alter the way we continue. Simply put, it's either we begin to dwell on our error, or we shake it off, learn from it, and move forward. And at the meeting this morning, our sister led us to Philippians 3:13-14. Apostle Paul said, Philippians 3:13-14, particularly verse 13, he said, I do not imagine myself to have achieved anything. I count not myself to have apprehended. Apostle Paul is even taking it beyond unpleasant circumstances or regrets. He's even saying that even if I had succeeded, I do not count myself to have arrived. You know, two instances now. You could find yourself and say, oh, I shouldn't have done that. This thing that I've done, I don't like the result. Apostle Paul said, even beyond that, even if I succeed, I don't boast in my present situation. He said, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. What are those things that are before? Verse 14. I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. What is the lesson here in summary? The lesson here is that even if you are regretting what is happening to you now, or you do not like what is happening to you now, it will be better. Even if now, if you now like what you have, oh, I have apprehended, I am okay, everything is working out for me, I have money, I have fame, I am the president of the United States of America, I have the prime minister of the UK at my beck and calling, I can walk out of the EU and stand alone, praise the Lord. I have attained. What this scripture is saying is that whatever level you are is a child's play to where you can get to. Whatever joy you have cannot be compared to the level that God can take you to. Now, our sister shared with us, he said, now if we have this assurance of this great future, something can prevent us from attaining. That thing is dwelling in the past. Failure. Oh, see what has happened to me now. It's the village people who are there. It's those who did not like me that they are doing. And you are dwelling in your failure. The village people sometimes that we give glory to, some of them are not, they don't even have a clue. The problem they are grappling with is more than you. Praise the Lord. I'm not saying that village people are not wicked. City people are more wicked. Because I come from village, so don't demonize those of us who are villagers. Sometimes we glorify the devil, whereas God, Jesus, has conquered the devil. Is that a song like that? Let's sing it. Hallelujah, Satan, you are in trouble. And God remains in my life. There is no failure. Our sister reminded us, I did post it in my note here. He said there is no failure, you have failed now. That somebody has not failed before. It cannot be patented to you. It's not, there's no copyright. If you have F9 parallel, somebody has had it before. It's not copyright. Whatever struggling you may be struggling with, it's not copyright. Now, I will now step it forward. For us to move forward, one thing she said is when we start to brood, when we start to dwell in the past and not shake it off, there are a few things that make us not to be able to shake it off and move forward. What will people say? Let them say. In fact, if people are not talking about you, you are not a newsmaker. You are not. Yeah, you may be alive, but you are not newsworthy. Not relevant. You are not newsworthy. For instance, this thing that I'm saying, if another person says it, the whole world will go away. Why? Because that person is newsworthy. If they are saying, somebody came to me, said, somebody said something and said something, I said, forget it. What I'm dealing with is more than it's more than, you know, those pedestrian things. Now, our elders, they say something, they say that you are inconsequential, or you are, something is wrong, not downstairs, some upstairs. If you carry elephant is a fable. This one thing that I want to say now is a fable. When we were growing up, they would tell us that in elephant, that you find all types of meat in elephant. When I grew up, I found out that it is not right. It's not right. They said that if you want fish, you will find it there. If you want any type of meat, they say it's contained in elephants. Because of the size. I think what they were telling us there was that there is no amount of meat that you want that you cannot find in elephants. That you have more than enough So it's not that you can find fish in elephant or chicken in elephant. What they are saying is that you will be satisfied. You don't need any other meat. Now, let me go back to the elder saying. The elder says, if you now carry elephant and you are now looking at rats passing by, does it make sense? That is lack of contentment. Eyes have not seen, nor has it come to the imagination of man, what God has prepared for you. Now, if you are delving in the past, it will disturb your moving forward. The only thing that we should use the past for is just lesson. Just let it be a lesson. Oh, if you made a mistake, I don't want to make that mistake again. Let me not bother. And if you want to be like Apostle Paul, who said, I don't count myself as I've apprehended. The lesson you can learn, even if you have succeeded, if you are successful at the moment, the lesson you can learn from the past, where the past has pleased you, is to say, thank God that I'm able to reach here. The lesson I can learn is that if I put more effort, it can be better. Don't go and sew clothes with a shoulder pad. Because as I round up, the only thing that tampers with the future, that makes the past to haunt us and cause an hindrance to our moving forward, is pride. Pride, if for instance you have attained, here I am, I have money, I don't have need for people. That is one element of pride. Another element of pride is because you have failed. Pride, lack of humility, can make one to say not to succumb to the failure and learn from it. You are still struggling. You have failed. The fact of it has not worked. Get an eraser. Erase it. Start all over again. It takes lack of pride for you to be able to do that. In project management, we are told that the hallmark of somebody who will succeed is when you are, you know, there are stages, for those of us who know about project management, there are stages. At every stage, you must check. Once you get, they say stages, so once you get to a certain stage, you check whether you are still on course. You move to the next stage, you check. If you move to the next stage and you have seen that you are out of course, don't let me use that word. The word I don't want to use is stronghead. Don't use stronghead. Cancel it. Go back. Start all over again. It takes humility to do that. It takes humility to accept defeat and say, okay, it doesn't matter. Let me start all over again. You will check, you will get there. Praise the Lord. Judges 16:20, that's our text. Judges 16:20 says, and he woke up out of his sleep and said, I will go out as at other times before and shake myself, and he will not that the Lord was departed from him. He didn't know. Samson did not know that God has departed from him. Pride will not allow him to know. To do self-re-examination and say that this thing has not worked. You are struggling with your wife, you are struggling with your husband. You do not know that there are things in your life for you to check and put right. Pride will not allow. Pride did not allow Samson to do self-examination and move forward. King Saul, in 1 Samuel 13:13, pride did not allow him to admit his errors. He said, and Samuel said to Saul, thou hast done foolishly. Thou hast not kept the commandment of the Lord Thy God which commanded thee for now, would the Lord have established thy kingdom upon Israel forever? It is pride that will not make you to erase what you have done wrong and move forward. Haman was full of himself. Haman is an example of somebody who has attained the level and he felt it that he can use his position. Nobody can correct you again because you are now at the level that you think you are powerful. Proverbs 29:23. A man's pride shall bring him low. A man's pride will bring him low. Even if he has attained a higher level, said a man's pride will bring him low. But honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. One way to check, you know, there are times that everybody will look wrong. You are convinced that everybody around you, they are wrong. Because you may have better information. But when it appears everybody is wrong, instead of struggling with them, keep quiet. The Bible says, in quietness, in silence shall your strength be. When I got this revelation, and I like one word, I didn't originate it, but I've imbibed it. He said, even if you say 1 + 1 = 5, you are correct. Shebi, you are the one who is correct. Continue now. Is it by force? You are correct. And if I'm awake, and I know that I will be struggling with, I will go under the duvet. Is very good in this country. You go and sleep. Sleep it off. Forget it. When it comes, all of us will see the consequence. We will see the results. If you are moving with people, wrong company, and they are, and you know that all these things they are saying, there is, leave them. There is no need to struggle over things. To avoid situations where pride, our present, our past will affect our future, let's do these three things I want to suggest. Number one, Proverbs 22:28. Remove not the ancient landmark which thy fathers have set. Remove. People can. There are tested ways. If you want to go to Lozelles, unless there is road work, this is the road that will lead to Lozelles. This is the only road that makes sense that will lead to Lozelles. It doesn't mean that you cannot go to Peribar roundabout. Go to Amstead Road, go via Villa Road, and come back to Lozelles. You will still get there. But why leave this one that has been tested? Why do you want to invent? When something is not broke, why do you want to? They say, honor your father and your mother so that your days shall be long. Why do you want to say this is a slave period? Why do you want to? They say, love your wife so that your prayers will be answered. Why do you want to test that if I don't love her, let me see whether my prayer will, whether I will go and bribe God? You cannot. It cannot happen. Oh, it's olden days. That is how you do it then. Now, we did it then. I've come back to university, and when I get there, I saw younger people than me. I see them there. And I see their lecturers. There are people with even more gray hair than me. So I now say that, if you say that people are old, why are you allowing old people to teach you? Does it make sense? Then you will come out and be saying, this is a new era. It is not a new era. Old people taught you. No, the fact is that what has been tested is tested. It's proven.
So let us do, when they say white is white, this is white, it's not black. What the Bible says, forget not the ancient landmarks, things that have been proven. Number two, we must be alive to our responsibilities. Matthew 13:25. While men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat. Sometimes, like I said earlier, we think that is it. One old woman is a witch, or our village people. Sometimes they are not. They are just doing their own thing. Even when there are villages witch, what do you expect a village witch to do? To kill, to steal, and to destroy. You can't stop that. Your own, what you can do is to be alive, so that. I was discussing with men and women yesterday. I said they should be praying for me. Because as long as you are living, there shall be afflictions. But what the Bible says is that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver them all from them all. The end result will be praise. Now, the only reason that, the only way that you can allow village people to have their way is when you sleep in the spirit. He said, why men slept, his enemy came, and so it's there. The only, there are so many ways that people can sleep in the spirit. When you are not praying, when you are not born again, when you are not alive to your responsibility, when you commit sin, you have departed, you are sleeping. When you are careless. So, we should not be careless. We should pray, do our own bit. Even when we go wrong, the Lord will correct it. And lastly, number three. 1 Corinthians 15:33. This is very important. 1 Corinthians 15:33. I wish we can read it in so many versions. Be not deceived. Be not, I want us to understand the be not deceived. Don't be fooled. Don't be deceived. Do not be tricked by false words. Thank you very much for that. Do not be tricked by false words. Don't let any new doctrine come to pass. Evil company does damage to good behavior. Don't say, they can't influence me. They may not influence you, but they can lead to number two, which we said earlier. They can lead to your sleeping. They can lead to your sleeping. Not everybody can get to a point that will say, one, even if you say 1 + 1 = 2, you have not gotten to that level. Praise the Lord. Do not be tricked by false words. Evil company does damage to good behavior. Show me your friends. I will tell you who you are. And that's the end of my encouragement. I lock us to pray. One thing you must understand is that there is no one who God cannot use. No one. Don't say I'm not a pastor. And one prayer point I'd like us to pray is that, Father, use me for my own greatness. For my own greatness. Teach me to know how to do, how to behave. Because your decision, even when you say yes or no, can make or mar your future. Teach me, O Lord, the decision to take, everything to do, to conduct myself, what to do things at the right time and the right thing to do. Help me, O Lord. Let my past not rupture my future. Even when I
had made mistakes, when things are not working well, Father, you are God who can correct all errors. You can correct all consequences. Even when Samuel turned to you, even though the damage had been made, but you still honored, you honored your word in his mouth. Jabez said enough was enough, and you made him to be honorable. Father, Lord, answer my prayers. Teach me the way to go. Teach me, O Lord. Teach me, teach me, teach me. In the name of Jesus, teach me the way to go. Teach me the way to go. Let my past not muddle up my future. Everything that my past is causing, or decisions that we have made, that our children have made, that are not working well now, Lord, correct them. Intervene, O Lord. Intervene, my Father, my God. You are the merciful Father. You are the Ancient of Days. You gave us our will to guide our destiny. Father, I put my life in your hands. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I put my life in your hands. Oh.